Hey guys, it's Dave from PMTV UK. I'm here today with this handsome fellow Geordie, Paul Hindmarsh. How's it going, dude? You good?
It's good. It's good. And it's nice to be doing videos right on my doorstep as well.
Yeah, man.
We're having to travel around the world and travel around the country to do it.
So. Our quaint little Newcastle store welcomes you. Yeah. So we have this beast of a Firehawk 1500 behind me.
Indeed.
Yes.
And you probably want to know something about it.
I would love to, and these guys would as well.
Okay, so Firehawk 1500 is an amplifier that came out at the NAMM show back in January. It's a bit of an odd one in some ways because it's not just a normal guitar amplifier. It looks like a traditional guitar amplifier and it's sort of masquerading as one. But really what we have there is a 1500 watt, yes, 1500 watt, stereo PA cabinet with a built-in Firehawk effects. It's like one of our floor unit multi-effects processors, like the pod. You can use it for all kinds of different things. So you could use it as a standalone guitar amplifier. You could use it to stream your music to. So you could use it as a really, really loud Bluetooth speaker.
Yeah. I was doing earlier today, and it sounds fantastic. The stereo is amazing in it.
Yeah, absolutely. So I mean, we could stream music from an iPad or from anything that's going to stream Bluetooth audio. For people who want to go out and use it as an amplifier for playing backing tracks with, we've got monitor inputs on the back there as well, so you could run a CD player. If anybody uses CD players anymore, an old 8-track, something like that. One of the reasons it sounds so good and it does all those different things is it's not like a normal guitar amplifier. So obviously in a traditional guitar amplifier, it hasn't got a lot of top end frequencies in there.
Right.
It doesn't reproduce a lot of the bottom end frequencies. This amplifier is very, very different in that way. So it's full range and it's flat response. It does that because there's six different speakers in there. So we have a 12-inch speaker in the center, so that's going to carry the majority of your guitar tone, mm-hmm. but it's also going to carry the bottom end of the sub frequencies from any of your backing
right,
tracks.
Cool.
It's also got two coax speakers either side. So that's your high frequency driver and your mid frequency driver together. Mm-hmm. And right in the center of the top there, we have a 1-inch high frequency driver as well.
That's
cool. So you get all the bottom end, you get all the stereo separation, and you get all the top end as well. So that's the sort of frequency spread that you need for acoustic guitars and for playing your backing tracks and everything.
That is remarkable, man.
Yeah, absolutely. It has all of the technology from our Amplifi range of products. So if you have an Android device or an iPad or a phone, you can edit all the sounds, and we're going to do some of that in a moment.
Yeah.
As a standalone guitar amplifier, you have over 250 different amp sounds and effects. All of the sounds that you would get from Pod HD, so mm-hmm. all 29 of those HD models, the HD reverbs, the HD overdrives, all of those,
right, cool.
they're all built into here as well. So yeah, it's just a lot of fun, but it can also be something that if you're a guitar player going out with backing tracks and you're doing like cafe gigs and you need to pick up an acoustic and plug an acoustic into it, you can do that as well.
It seems very intuitive to any aspect you could need it for as a musician, as a guitar player.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
you just rock up with one very loud amplifier, backing tracks, acoustic guitar, electric guitar, and it's going to perform all those different tasks and do it very well.
Excellent, man. Well, let's hear some sounds.
Okay, cool. So, I mean, the sound that we just started there. So, I mean, if you can see the app, you can see that the way we use this, line six, we could have put a touch screen in the amplifier. We could have put a really fancy, expensive LCD screen in there, but it would have cost a lot of money.
Yeah.
Chances are everybody's walking around with one of those touch screens in the pocket anyway.
Yeah.
So by using the app as a remote control, it means that very quickly on any of the sounds, I can go in and I can edit any of the parameters and save any of those parameters. So I can save a preset and I can share it around the world as well. But running through the app, you can see I've got the Variax connected, but we're just using the magnetic pickups. We've got a volume pedal, a wah pedal, a stomp pedal, a modulation pedal, and there's the amp model there running through into delays and reverbs and so on. So if I want to edit one of those amp sounds, so we can see I'm currently on a Bogner Uber Shell, so I think if I just let you hear. We with some delay.
Yeah, that sounded great, man.
And the delay's in stereo, so you'll definitely be hearing it in stereo because we have we're just running the line outs from the back there. But it's actually stereo in the room as well. So yeah. We're hearing it just from one amplifier, but we can hear the ping pong delays between those. If I want to just edit that patch, I can click on the amp icon, and now I see all the different amps. So it's like a virtual guitar store of different amps.
Yeah.
Like I said before, we have 78 of the normal amplifier models in there, which is pod form models, plus the 29 HD models. So if I was to maybe go for some of the British sounds, you can see I've got normal models at the bottom, but then I have, if I tap on this, I can go in and pick. My personal favorite is, you know, something like the old J45. I can dial that in. I could change the cabinet model on that, 25 different cabinets. So I can go from everything from a little Fender mini twin, the little Christmas gifty 2x2 inch speaker.
And that does sound great though, to be fair, with a stereo it sounds great.
And then I can instantly switch to one of the bigger.
It's got a lot of thump to it. It feels like it's got a lot of bass response to it.
Absolutely.
It sounds
great. And we're still hearing it like fairly quietly in this room as well. I mean, it really does kind of throw out the sound. And then I can start to tweak those, add different modulation effects to that. And it's the same process for everything. You just tap on what you want in that signal path, click on the effect. You know, everybody's got a pretty good idea what this orange phase
is. It's just being a nerd as well, to be fair. It's laid out beautifully. Like the little graphics and stuff are great.
Yeah.
Line 6 have really outdone themselves.
Yeah, so I mean, on that subject, it's a great resource for people who want to learn about effects as well.
Yeah.
You know, so if you come into your local guitar store and you're overwhelmed by the amount of pedals in the glass case that's in every store that we're going to now, and you're wondering what they all do, you could have this and you could go through and you know, get a good idea what all these different pedals are going to sound like. I mean, so, you know, 250 different sounds and effects. It's important to know that all of those are built into the amp. This is just a remote control.
Yeah.
The app is free as well, so there's no upcharge or anything on that. So you buy the amp, you get all of this, you know, whether you're controlling it on your phone or your iPad or anything.
So the app's Android as well as
it is, yeah.
Apple, yeah?
Absolutely, yeah. Cool. Yeah, I mean, moving through there, I mean, it's probably worth just, you know, if we talk about, that's the edit page. Mm-hmm. We then have a page where we can go online and we can search for famous players, famous guitar sounds.
Yeah.
Really handy for me because when I go to guitar stores these days, a lot of young kids or younger people like to mention guitar players that I've never ever heard of before. And instead of me, sometimes whole genres of music that I've never heard of before, I can go in and I can search and I can download tones for, you know, whether it's Gary Moore or whether it's Keith Richards or any of those guys, you know. But it can also, like, you can do a search for a lot of great stuff on there. I then have, obviously I've got a tuner in there, and I have, the app will stream back any of the music that I have in there as well. Mm-hmm. So if I had backing tracks in there, I could stream the backing tracks. And it'll also do the thing that Amplifi does as well, where if I play one of my tracks in there, it'll go to the Line 6 tone cloud. Mm-hmm. It'll search for up to, I think it's about 80,000 tones last time we checked on there, and it'll actually search and download tones that are appropriate for the track that track that you're playing, yeah. So yeah, really, really, really clever bit of gear. If I wanted to, I could edit all of those sounds just from the amp itself. So that's a really important thing to remember. So you can use the app for really quick, easy editing. You'd then save the sounds to the amp. But when you go to a gig, you don't need to have your app connected. You wouldn't connect your phone to it in a gig situation, really. It just then becomes an amp with a whole lot of patches in. But you know, you can, you know, take it to the gig, use it your guitar sound, push it back on its kickstand so it's projecting the sound and looks like an old Fender amplifier. Plug your backing tracks into it, maybe even plug a bit of kick drum or a feedback from your desk into the monitor ends there.
It
as
does
well.
Everything, so, man, it's insanity.
Yeah, absolutely.
See, the top is laid out as well, not too dissimilar. So if you haven't got the app set up, you can tweak things on the top as if it was a real amp, or as if you've got a Firehawk, like three-band EQ, you've got a drive, your effects level and your reverb level.
But I can also change more things than that as well. So if I want to go in and deep edit things, if I want to change the speaker cabinets, if I want to change the mics, if I want to change the different modulation effects, I can do all of that as well directly from the top of the amp as well. So if you're terrified of the idea of using your phone or using an iPad, you don't have to do that. It's just kind of good thing to show in the video because it makes it so visual how it works, you know. So it's like having one of our Firehawk effects units. Some guys would use one of those and they'd plug it into maybe two stage monitors. The stage monitors would be at the front. This is the same kind of thing, but it's for somebody who wants a much more traditional look and wants the benefits of having two great stage monitors, but wants one amplifier that looks cool looking amplifier, you know, cool, traditional looking amplifier, yeah.
There's been a couple of times I've been at gigs myself and I've saw people with Firehawks and they've had like the iPad on the mic stand at the front. And as they're playing, they just change amps and stuff and going from song to song. As opposed to having like a switching system on the deck?
Yeah, so you could use an FBV3 with this. So FBV3 is the new pedal. If you have an FBV3, it's all color-coded. So traditionally, Line 6 delays were green right back from the DL4 delay modeler, the modulation modeler and stuff as well. So if I wanted to change those on the floor, I can see that the green pedal on that is going to be the delay and toggle that on and off. That's a more traditional way for somebody like me probably to play, and like probably most of us. The idea of having the app on a mic stand and being able to edit those sounds, I mean, that's the flexibility that would give you, would just be so, if it would be tremendous. So if you're the kind of guitar player who just really likes to go out and create like wacky sounds and edit sounds and do all that crazy stuff, being able to just play a chord and dial it and change all those different things is, a lot of power there to be able to do that. Yeah. I mean, the other thing that it'll work in conjunction with other things as well. So we have an effects loop on there. Mm-hmm. So because this is a touchscreen and it's so easy to use, I can also drag and drop and rearrange pedals as well.
Oh.
So I can put the delay in front of the amplifier.
Like in front of a preamp, that kind of thing.
Yeah, just in front of the amp, yeah. I've also got a stereo effects loop on there. So the stereo effects loop, I could grab that, and if it's doing delays or reverbs or anything, I can actually have it behind the amplifier, but I can also pick it up and I can position that preset by preset in the signal chain as well.
Very cool.
Yeah, so some really good things in that. If you have the Variax, and let's face it, we all should, the app itself and the amp knows that you've got a Variax connected, so it opens up this really cool page. So let's just get a normal sound. Okay, if I open up this Variax page and connect the Variax, so I'll sorry, power the Variax up, mm-hmm. you can see on the app there, hopefully, that as I change the sounds, it's actually learning what I'm doing in terms of the switching. It also learns where the tone control is, so as I turn the tone control there, it's learning that, but really interestingly,
I'm
really interesting underneath that, if I have a tuning page, so I can change each string actually from the app as well. So that's preset by preset. So I can have a patch where I have a Strat model. I can tune any string, any direction. Okay, so if I want to have another patch where I was all in E flat or where doing this sort of, I mean, if I wanted to do an open D thing, say I want to experiment with some slide things, if I've done that right, I should now have the guitar tuned to an open D chord.
That's remarkable.
Isn't that awesome?
Genuinely.
Isn't that awesome? So, connect the Variax to that. Obviously, the Variax has got acoustic sounds in here as well. So I could have a stage amp. I could rock up at a gig, have a Variax, have one preset, which was a drop-tuned Dobro. The next preset could be a drop-tuned Les Paul, you know. Yeah. I could then have a Telecaster model in an open Keith Richards-y type of tuning. And then I could have a Strat in E-flat for one of those songs as well and switch between them. And one foot switch is going to change the guitar, the tuning, the amp model, and the effects. So I've got all of that flexibility. Then I've got the flexibility of actually playing the backing tracks through there, maybe putting just a bit of my backing vocals through here alongside that guitar sound so I can hear it. So because it's a stage monitor, I can do that as well. Or I could just wheel it out into the garden and turn it up really loud and annoy the whole of Newcastle.
It's what everyone wants to do. It's what everyone wants to do.
Yeah.
But yeah,
so that's Firehawk 1500, a lot of different things in there. It's loud.
I'm genuinely blown away by what this can do. And you could do a lot, but I haven't really sat down, especially with you, and spoke about everything it can do. It's I'm a bit lost for words.
Well, there's a first.
Yeah, for me, it'd be lost for words, there's a first. If you want any more info, any more than what you've already got, please check out pmtonline.co.uk or speak to one of our forever expanding 15 stores. Each one of those stores has its own Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one or them all if you're feeling that nice. I'm Dagan.
And I'm Paul.
And we will see you next time. Cheers, guys.